Wildfires are uncontrolled combustion processes. There are small wildfires and some of them are very large. Some of them are slow, some of them are very fast. Some of them are good for the environment, some of them are bad and put populations, property, and environments at risk. It is very important to identify the bad fires so we can fight them. And the best way to fight them is to first understand how they spread and how they can damage the ecosystem. This is actually now even more important because climate change is modifying wildfire behavior and we are seeing more of the big and bad fires happening.
We think about some of the mega fires and the very large fires we're seeing in Canada or Australia. Understanding how these fires start and having a physical understanding of them can help us engineer solutions for the prevention or suppression of these fires. A very big research problem these days is the wildland-urban interface. So we are building more and more into rural areas, and some of these areas are prone to fires and we're used to fires, but as we're changing the environment around it, we are changing the conditions for these fires. Wildfire ignition is becoming a bigger and bigger issue to solve. As the temperatures around the globe are rising, understanding under which conditions different fuels or different areas of the world might ignite is becoming key. If you look at Indonesia, if you look at Russia and Siberia, some of these areas are experiencing bigger droughts and drier weather, which is causing more and more ignition. So we work on understanding how these wildfires begin so that we can prepare for them and avoid damage to people, the environment, and property.
The work of Dr. Francesco Restuccia from King's Engineering is very important to protect these communities that are in rural locations, protect their lives, their property, and the environment.